Hey, it is your buddy, Peace and Harmony, with you here today. We're zooming in and focusing in on a very important aspect of that you can identify if you are in sort of the gaslighting or brainwashing stage with a malignant narcissist or a psychopath. And that is the experience of resenting or disliking people who you have never really met. It comes from a feeling of paranoia, suspicion, and hypervigilance that has originated from the imprinting of self-doubt, self-distrust that oftentimes is imprinted within you by this malignant individual because of their need to be the number one, because of their need to be the charming, to be the showstopper, to take the limelight, to take the spotlight, to be the loudest, the prettiest, the most handsome, the richest, the funniest, whatever it is, the mostest, this individual will basically seek this entitlement, and the relationship will become out of balance. In the beginning, it might be a welcome change. This person might be entertaining, they might be funny, their wealth might be attractive, their physical beauty might be attractive, the way that they're so handsome or manly or strong or whatever it is in the beginning that got you hooked. Eventually, the devaluation stage, there's always going to be a stage where things get sorted out as the relationship continues. And that's when the brainwashing, the gaslighting, when you begin to kind of abandon your own inner boundaries, abandoning your own sense of self, and really being true to yourself, being authentic to yourself, standing up for your needs, standing up for your values, standing up for what you know to be true or good for you. Little by little, those become to become eroded. And now, almost as if you've had a new engine installed in the car, you've got a Ford motor and a Chevy truck, you're now being run through this gaslighting program. You're now being brainwashed. The emotional content of things no longer seem to be what they were. You don't seem to look at life the same way. You don't look at other relationships or friendships, or even your family, or even your own children, the same way. Things become a little bit illusory or unreal. And sticking up for people or being present for natural events that you normally would have been there for, just no longer seem important. Only this person's ideology and the way of thinking becomes important to you, and you oftentimes will find that people who are in this gaslighting and brainwashing stage begin to dislike and resent people who they have never met. It's basically, it becomes very pervasive, and oftentimes it's very fear-based because of the gaslighting, because of the brainwashing, because people can no longer begin to put their own thoughts or cognitions together. They become very fragmented. They become very much mixed in a cocktail of fear and arousal, and need to be addicted to this person and think along the way that this individual thinks rather than their own natural inherent values and thought cognition process. They basically abandon this, just unravel it, or fray at the ends as they take on this malignant narcissist or psychopath's thought pattern, their gaslighting, their manipulation, their brainwashing, where things that you normally could relate to in a very easy, comfortable manner become, sort of flipped and contorted and distorted. So you basically, begin to abandon these in order to please them or, to really promote the addiction to whatever it is that they're making you feel, the trauma bond, keeping them pleased, keeping them happy, keeping their entertainment going, keeping their charm going, whatever it is, you're trying to fan the fires, if you will. And so oftentimes people will find that they no longer have the same value system that they once did. In other words, they might have valued education, they might have valued other services, they might have valued other people, their children, things that they normally would feel comfortable on. They begin to get a sort of insecurity. They begin to really sort of abandoning or being resistive to natural comfort. In other words, they begin to dislike or resent people, events, or things which normally or naturally were not a source of a threat. So new threats begin to come up in the environment. People are threatened at the neighbors, the coworker, other siblings become, there becomes this whole slew of paranoia that is part of the gaslighting and brainwashing saga. So if you have experienced this, realize that this is oftentimes it is just a result of that gaslighting or brainwashing, and you will return to normal. You will begin to come back to your own inherent and natural authentic value system and nurture those. It is really those that were abandoned or rejected by the narcissist, by the psychopath, or invalidated for so long that you threw these away to try to maintain this relationship, or they were really just dissolved in a trauma bond relationship, which really can only take place for so long until eventually the pain becomes so great that you have to let the relationship go and come to terms with your own sense of I am and becoming empowered and really more aligned with your body, mind, and spirit. Oftentimes that was really thrown off center and off kilter in a relationship with a malignant narcissist or a psychopath. It is your buddy, peace and harmony with you here today. And I truly hope that these videos, that they do help. Please share and please subscribe for more great tools, videos, discussion, and support.